tons of wires, fans, Allen key. Now this is the heart of it all. This is the brains of the cooling system. The cooling system itself. So we have a filter here, a big ass filter. We've got a plastic bag. Aren't plastic bags just beautiful? You know, when you look at them in the right light.
I need to remember. Sometimes there's so much beauty in the world. I feel like I can't take it.
If I had to guess, what I'm doing here is I'm gonna be thermal paste on there, and this goes on top. I bolt it down here. Then, tutorial time. I need to install the radiator into the actual case before I just put it onto the CPU. That also means that I need to figure out what my fan configuration is gonna be. Yeah. Feels like Christmas. I don't want to pour these out too rigorously. But there you have it. I have to remove this piece now. There's screws behind these wires that are just hidden away here. So I'm gonna start with those ones. Good. All right, everything I need to install the is right here. I selected the bag that says AMD AM4 because that is the type of CPU that I have. I have three fans, and these are gonna be outtake. These should be the screws that I need. It does have some text on there, miscellaneous, HW, H150, H170. I don't know what any of that means. So I should have 12 screws, and just by finger tightening it, that does fit. Perfect, awesome, nice, excellent. Put the cooler out of the way here. The radiator is gonna be upside down. These tubes are gonna be on the right side of the case. I'm gonna have all the cables facing this direction, and that way they're facing the back of the case once it's installed. So, you guys from around here? That's cool, that's cool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Where's the last watcher? Oh, it's right here. Right here in my hand.
Do you know where I can find some little silver triangular pyramid caps, roughly 1.5 inches in diameter?
Right here in my hand.
Cool. There's two possible configurations for my AIO. I can either put it on the front, or I can put it along the top, and I think I'm gonna go with the top, because I don't really know why. Nice. The cables are through that hole. And so now I'm gonna open this little bag with my left hand, and I'm gonna finger tighten this one first. That's probably my best bet. And then I'll do the same to another one in the opposite corner. That way, even if I accidentally let go of this, it's not gonna just fall. Now that's holding on nice, and that's holding on nice. That's free to let go of now. Unless some freak accident happens and the screws just like vanish, maybe, or something, because of some like multiverse defect. Maybe that could happen, so that wouldn't be good, but. So, right, the next one. Bottom one's linked. Now the top one. This looks a little strange to me. I think I just need to trust that everything is how it's supposed to be, because I'm following the tutorial exactly. I'm doing what he's saying. There shouldn't be any problems. Except there is one major problem. Yep, I put the metal parts on backwards. I have to redo it. This way. Now it is correct. They're like wings that go up like that. They're not like legs that come down. Now I can attach this properly. Now the top one is latched. So if I bring the bottom one on now. Oh, is that it? No. See, this is the type of thing that it's just, it looks so easy. And why is it not working. I just need to be calm. That's it. It just was like a couple millimeters I just needed. Oh, now it's on. You shouldn't latch the bottom on first. It's better to latch the top part on first. And then the other thing that you want to do is to just make sure that they're tightened evenly. So that's important. So I'm just going to loosen them each just a little bit so that I can tighten them synchronized together and feel the pressure. Okay, and that's feeling kind of finger tight. He didn't say how tight you want to make this, so I'm going lightly finger tight. I could squeeze this a little bit more, but that's it. Anyway, we got our cooler in. What's up? You might have to turn up your volume again.
Well, man, I don't need the mic right in my face when I'm eating.
Okay, well, I'll just show you what I need to have figured out here. Basically, I have this little cable here, and it's like a 3-pin connector, and apparently I'm supposed to put it onto this, which is 4 pins, and I'm just not really sure how to do that.
Does the connector have like a ridged section that looks like it would slot in between the two spots there?
Oh yeah, I see it. Yeah, thank you, Jeff. Very much appreciated. Now I can start working on plugging in all of the fans into this hub, and then figuring out where to plug in the SATA connector that plugs into this fan hub. This. I'm gonna take these panels off. This way I can keep this in a nice spot like that. And everything should be able to reach it just fine. I also wanna make sure that the SATA cable is able to reach the power, which it obviously will be able to. So maybe I don't have to think about that. These are from this fan, these are from the middle fan, and these are from the fan on the right. I'm doing it so that they correspond by number. So this is from the same fan, and then this is gonna be from the next fan, and then the next fan. I don't know if it matters if the numbers correspond, but for peace of mind, I'm plugging them in that way.